My appeal is to the president or anyone else who can help me. I don't want my baby to pass on. And if it's possible, if there's a way that we can raise the money and get the money for her to go home and for her to get the drug, I'd really appreciate it.
My name is Ruth Mboro. I'm the mother to Neillah Mirera. She's 1 year, 2 months old. I gave birth to Neillah on 14th of February, 2018. And when I gave birth to her, it was a very lovely moment. I had a normal birth in Mata Hospital. When you give birth, you want to see your baby. That's the first thing you want to see. And when I saw her, I didn't notice anything. There was absolutely nothing to be seen. Until now we went to the ward, that's when I realized her eyes were a bit yellow. On asking the doctor, because the doctor came in the next day, on asking the pediatric, he was like, no, that is too mild, and with time, it's going to end. Yeah, like it's something normal. With time, it's going to end. So I assumed it, and then after 3 days, we were discharged, we went home. And that's where our journey began. At 1 week, at 2 weeks, you're supposed to go back to the doctor for checkup, both you and the baby. But at 1 week, the yellowing of the eyes was much more. So I was a bit concerned. We went to Gertrude's Don Home. When we got there, the doctor looked at her. And he was like, it's not that severe that needs to be exposed to like UV lights and all, but this, it's just a matter of exposing her to sunlight and with time it will end. He gave her some medication and we went home. I exposed her to light 2-3 days and it disappeared by itself. So we started going for the normal injections every month one, month two, but Neillah was not growing. Because you could compare the progress of Neillah with other babies. Hers was, she was growing with grams. Like the first time we went back, because I gave birth to her with 2.9 kgs. First time she was 3.2. But the doctors were like, for as long as she has increased, it doesn't matter. What really can be of concern is if she's decreasing in weight. Her milestones were not the same. That was the problem, but people just tell you kids are different, they go different, they grow differently. So just take time and she'll grow eventually. At 3 months, a kid is expected to have at least have a stable head. The head should stand by itself and all, but she was still very floppy. So we went to the doctor, and then the doctor told us to just continue feeding the normal feeds. I continue breastfeeding her and everything will be fine. And we did that up to 6 months now. I rather think around 5 months. At around 5 months now, we went back to the doctor, because now at 5 months, still no head support, still no milestone achieved. It's now worrying. That's when she had a vitamin D test done here in Nairobi Hospital, and she was found with rickets. So she was kept under a drug called Abidec for 3 months to improve her vitamin D levels, and she was also injected because her rickets had her vitamin D levels were very low. So we went home, took the drug for 3 months, which she was supposed to come back for review after the 3 months. Came back, the vitamin D levels were perfectly okay, but still no milestones. So now the doctor told us that we have to resume occupational therapy because she had low muscle tone. Her muscle tone was very low. Started doing OT, we did OT for like 2-3 months. And still, okay, very slow, but something was just not adding up. I wasn't satisfied as a parent. Around November, that's when I seeked my doctor, her pediatric, advised me to go seek a neurologist. So we went and saw a neurologist. And then the doctor, the first question when we went, me and the dad, he asked us if we're related. Told him we cannot be related because the dad is Luo and I'm Kikuyu, so it's way impossible. Said okay. He told us that there's a test that has to be done, and yeah, that test, it's a gene mutation test, will be able to determine what really is wrong with the baby. So he told me that your baby has something called SMA, spinal muscular atrophy, and it's a genetic disorder. It's a gene mutation that affects the motor neurons, whereby the nerves in your body tend to shed off. And you know, the nerves are sent signals to your muscles to move or to act to something. So if the nerves are shedding off, the muscles become weak. When your muscles become weak, now you have low muscle tone, and yeah, you become floppy. And then he said, they remember that, what I can advise you, enjoy the time you have with your baby, because you never know. So I asked him, does it mean that this particular disease has a lifespan? He said, yes. And I asked him what the lifespan is. He told me, generally 6 months, but this is a baby who's already past 6 months, so she might not get to 2 years. The doctor said that the only way we can improve her, make her life easy, that is what he's saying, is by putting a tracheostomy and a tube, a feeding tube, and fundoplication. By tracheostomy is you surpass all this from the nose to the, you surpass it straight to the trachea to provide air into the lungs. It will make it better for her because she won't have to struggle to inhale the oxygen around. So we did that. Feeding tube is because clearly, because of her weak muscles, the baby tends to feed and then some food goes to the lungs, then leading to the aspiratory pneumonia.
Help yourself with this.
Neillah is a very brilliant girl. She's really sharp. I remember there's a doctor, there's a nurse who once told me that anytime they go to do a particular activity for Neillah, she looks at them until they feel the need to explain what they're doing to her, because she has these intimidating eyes. Like, you really feel the need to say, Mama, I'm about to sanction you, I'm about to do this and this and this. But she'll still give you a blank stare. Like, what do you want to do to me? She's that kind of a girl, very sharp, very, very happy. And she's a fighter. Like, there were days whereby the doctor was even telling my mom-in-law that if she goes to next week, we thank God. But surprisingly, she pulls through. I feel grateful because, one, I've get to know Neillah. I've had time with her. And I know there are people out there who are looking for their kids. I already have her. So despite everything, I'm just grateful for her. Being that I'm the one in this platform, I first of all want to thank everyone for giving me this platform. My appeal is to the president or anyone else who can help me. I don't want my baby to pass on. And if it's possible, if there's a way that we can raise the money and get the money for her to go home and for her to get the drug, I'd really appreciate it. I really want to at least say that she was helped, to at least say that we tried the drug and it worked, but I did something as a parent. And not
stop it at the point where the doctors told me she has 2 years and that's it. No, I went an extra mile. So if we can get the Speranza and maybe Neillah to be cured, I'd really appreciate it.
And your Georgia, which are cutie cutie. Someone got cutie cutie cutie.
Boom, boom, boom.